Everybody, this is Adam Stewart. He's our fiddle player at the Kimco Jam Band. He's joining me today.
Hello.
Many of you have children that need guidance. Adam teaches fiddle and violin.
Watch out.
Both kinds of fiddle.
We had a little joke in the band the other day. We said, because people always ask, what's the difference between fiddle and violin? And I said about 30 grand a year, 30 grand a year income. We're going to play a little, couple tunes just to get us dialed in here, and then we're going to jump into our Hobo Gym music. Are you guys doing okay?
Sam, she bought that at the event.
Just like a knife. He was a banker for making, so he loved her all his life. He bought her a mansion on the mountain with a phony gun and a lot of land. The paradise became prison. Every time he talks about her, you can see the fire in his eyes, and he can say, I would walk through the sun, eat my rose in paradise. They had a man to tend the garden. On her while he was gone. Some say they ran away together. Say that Gardner left alone. But now the banker, well, he's no man. Hanson's crumbling down. He sits all day and stares at the gun. Her was in the bath. Every time he talks about her, you can see the fire in his eye. And he'd say, I would walk through hell someday. To keep my rose in paradise. Now there's a rose out in the garden. Beauty cuts just like a knife. It's a sunset, even goes in the wintertime. Blooms in the dead of the night. Take a try to run up to our first break and as an old joke. I apologize we got started a little late, but we'll finish late too. How about that? That's just the way that goes. We had just a little goof up on my schedule here, and it was 4, then it was 7, then it was 7:30. And, you know, I have trouble with math anyway, so I really do. Anyway, thank you for being here. I think this is the biggest group I've ever seen in the tent. For me, anyway, for me. And I probably came here for you. Is this all your family? I hope so.
Yeah!
Well, how many of you are country music fans in here anyway? They're always the loudest, they're the proudest, the ones that represent the rock group. Anyway, it's okay. What do you think of? Alright. I'm gonna do one more before I jump into Hobo's music. I recorded this song on my third CD with Waylon Jennings Band. In the middle of stage 4 throat cancer, mind you. All day rain, wind, and moan. That's the day that I was born. That old chin crop was growing across the yard. This day my man left me. Shame that you had me. Said you hit the road. Never want some mine. And I ought to somehow mention what my grandma's old and pensive is. The reason why I'm standing here today. Got all my cuts me learning, living that a churning pain, got real business, hey. I've been to Georgia on a fast train, honey, and I wasn't home though yesterday. Got a good whisper raising and an angry education. I don't need you all.
Thank you.
Jim recorded like 75 songs. He wrote over 700 of them, but recorded 75 that I could see. And Adam and I have started on the journey of learning a bunch of those. And there's a lot of words and a lot of material to get processed on these songs. But I commit to you that I'll keep his music alive in Alaska. You know? It's a lot to process, though, and this winter I'll have it down where we have 2 or 3 hours of his music and we'll be playing a little bit. So I'm gonna play a song that I used to do with Jim all the time, and the song is called "Girl from the North Country." Everybody. Before I play this, I want to tell you a quick story about this guitar. This is important. Sam, the guy that did the logo on Jim's shirts, actually designed these little coins, and my friend Jim Miller. Is Sam here? He's right there. Give it up to Sam. Sam, hold your hand up. I'm probably going to change into that Hobo Jim shirt in a minute because this one's soaked already in here. But he made these little wooden coins, and I glued it to this guitar because it's going to stay on this guitar forever. And the reason it is because this is the very first guitar Hobo Jim ever gave to me.
And, we did good.
And I played it for a long time before I could buy my own guitars that were of any substance. So the story behind this guitar actually is Jim was playing the Kenai Classic. There was a fishing tournament. And Yamaha, who made this guitar, by the way, if you don't know, Yamaha makes fantastic guitars, even though I like American made. If you ever find old Yamaha guitars, the luthiers from Japan were phenomenal. Anyway, he gave me this guitar, and at first I was like, oh, okay, it's cool, it's Yamaha. He goes, no, you gotta play it. So Yamaha told Jim, when he did the Kenai Classic, they sponsored it. They said, you can pick any one of these guitars out of this book in the first 5 pages. And Jim said he flipped one more page, and were the ones that said, call for price. And this was the guitar he took. So 24 hours ago, I hadn't used this guitar in 20 years. And 24 hours ago, this guitar had no strings on it, no pins, no pickup in it, no anything. And I worked till 4 this morning on it as I was playing and resurrected this because I thought, what a great guitar to play today, you know, for all of you. So let me see it. Because Jim used this guitar on stage for years. So anyway. And Susie, I tried to use your, were those mastodon pins you gave me? For when I got stage 4 throat cancer about 11 years ago, and I got all these gifts and things from people, and Susie gave me guitar pins that go in here made out of mastodon, but they were just, I need to have them ground. I was going to put those in here and put in this guitar, and I'll still do that, so I kept those. So when Jim would come to my shows or I'd go to his, this was one of the songs that we'd always play together. So I thought I'd start it off with this. Any traveler to the North Country Fair with the wind too heavy on the borderline, please say hello. The woman is there. She wants one, a true love of mine. See, for me, their hair's hanging down, curls and falls all down her breast.
My granddaughter's teacher.
See, for me, their hair's hanging down. That's the way I remember. If you're traveling to the North Country Fair with the wind too heavy on the borderline, please say hello. The woman is there. She wants one, a true love of mine. See for me, their hair's hanging down, curls and fall all down her breast. See for me, their hair's hanging down, 'cause that's the way I remember this. If you go the river's free, so the river for me, that she's been a cold so warm. Keep her from the howling wind. If you're traveling to the North Country Fair where the wind's in heavy and so real, please for me that she's here, cold so warm, keep her from the house today. Could be. He'll play some violin for you.
Mozart.
I was thinking about Adam and I's summer on the way out here. And, in March, we were kind of halted, you know? The band was kind of just not working. And then all of a sudden, we got working too much, almost. And I think tonight is Adam and I's 75th gig since March. Yeah. Just a few. And, yeah. Thursday morning, I'm playing the National. And I'm going to perform on Johnny Cash's Hideaway Farm out in Dixon, Tennessee. I'm going to play a song that I actually wrote about 15 years ago. And it's been 12 weddings and 3 divorces. And, no divorces. Anyway, I'm playing Saturday acoustically for my buddy Jimmy Weber as he walks down the aisle. And, I'm going to play that song because Jim actually produced the CD that it's on. The Educated Man CD, actually. So I'll play you the song and replace that. And Jim loved this. He was proud because I don't write as much as he did, obviously, and he was always encouraging me to do that. So I'm going to play that song for you right now. The day that I first saw my heart is to be looking back, it seems so strange to me how two strangers just meet. 'Cause you could search a lifetime on every street and every town. One day out of the blue it happened. The right horn comes around, and your world's no longer empty. Sad songs no longer bring you down. Yes, we write our own love story, when the right horn comes around. No man is good at being lonely, lost and feeling blue. There's nothing in the world I want to help a man get through. Said, oh child, what do we say? The power in her hand, pick you up anytime you're down. When the right one comes around, and your world's no longer empty. Sad songs no longer break down. Yes, you write our own love story, when a right one comes around. Songs no longer bring me down. Guess we write our own love story, when the right one comes around. You're gonna write your own love story, when the right one comes around.
Thank you.
can't even believe I wrote that. I'm a terrible writer as a whole. But that song has been good. You guys, is it too loud back there?
No.
Is it good enough?
It's
good?
Great.
All right. What do you think of this guy right here with the little guitar and the stick? You want to play him some violin for a minute? Just because of the other kind of fiddle. Play some of that Campbell Soup commercial music.
This guy over here asked for some, but it's all right.
Oh my.
Is this like a fancy chocolate commercial with Swiss Smokers? Adam has been in the Kim Build Deer Band now 8 years. 7 years.
7 years.
I told you I can't count. 7 years. Our drummer has been in there 14 or
double year, 14.
15. 70 yeah. years old and still whacking. Alright. Hey, you know what song I started doing the other night? We played this Jim recorded this song. He wrote this song called The Rock. Have you ever heard this song? I hadn't played it for a year. I think I played it with Jim in this tent, actually, last year at the fair. And Etta James recorded this, Leroy Parnell, Randy Travis, Amazing Rhythm Aces. It's a little hard to track down, actually, but once you get into it, then... When you wake up in the morning and you wonder why no one's beside you, where I usually lay, and you think you hear the sound of distant thunder, that's just your old rock rolling away. I was a rock standing strong for you. There was nothing I wouldn't do, no matter the cause. I was ready to pay. Now you say I'm only holding you down, like some rock you've been dragging around. My hours are out, now roll away. I'm rolling away on a downhill grade. But I'm gonna come to rest on a mountain of love someday. Cause I finally understand
when you're resting on shifting sand or even a rock. We'll go rolling away.
Infection for 2 weeks and I'm finally done with them and now I'm really like it's making me thirsty. I'm looking over there like I haven't had food for a year. Can I have pork chops? I need anything light. None of that black licorice beer.
Sit by my grandpa's side and wait for the chickens to buy. and grandma yelled, and that's the biggest war I ever saw. You land that one, sure enough, we'll take him into town and give him stuff. But when your mama's not looking, we'll hang that sucker on the wall. Fish in for chicken, you ought to get a lick. Black ones, black ones, yellow ones, red ones, it don't matter just as long as I get one. Mama finds out, you ought to get a lick. Mama don't like nobody, mama don't like nobody. Mama don't like nobody, fish in for chicken.
I'm teared up. Cheers, everybody.
We love you, man.
Love you too. Oh, that's so good. So, a little secret that I have this drink holder on my music stand because I had radiation, stage 4 throat cancer, and now I have dry mouth from that. It's a true story. And so, when you're singing, you're doing this. All every verse, so it just dry your mouth. So I have that there, and it doesn't matter really what liquid, but every now and then sipping on a beer is nice, you know. So I have to have something though, is my point. That's why I have water there. So, but I mean, I can still sing, right? And I lived. It was stage 4, right? You know? I cut these fingers off in 1998, and then 10 years later, or 11 years later, I got stage 4 throat cancer. So I'm applying for my blue sticker.
Yeah, there you go.
Randy, you doing good over there? How about a hand for our sound guy, Randy Stevens, right here? For those of you that don't know Randy, not only does he run sound, but he is a monster singer and piano player, just so you know. So, he is. I'm not just kissing up to him because he has control of my fate right now. I grew up learning from him, so, and watching him play and listening to him, and he's fantastic entertainer. So you just never know who's in the room, you know? I'm your daddy. I hate to tell you. You got all your fingers and good eyes. Are you guys having fun? Yeah. I was nervous to do this show, I'll tell you, because it's pressure to do Jim's stuff, you know? He's like my hero, my dad, best friend, big brother, mentor, and so. And the other night I played in this tent with Frank Iarossi. I'm sure he'll wander down here to heckle me later. And he's fantastic. But it was the first time I played on this stage in this tent without Jim. I played like the end of the fair last year with him, and then I went hunting, and then of course we lost him in October, so it was a bit surreal, still is, to sit up here, because every time I've ever played on this stage is with Jim. So anyway, so let's have a hand for Hobo Jim. I hope he's listening. Yeah! Songs I was going to learn first. It's crazy because so many, well, Adam and I were talking outside, until you really dive into dissecting his music and learning it, you don't realize, I mean, you might, but even us close to him and musicians, you don't realize just how intelligent, what a genius mind he had, how he wrote, how he thought, how he structured songs, and until you get into those songs. Huh? We're just talking about that outside.
Absolutely.
Yeah. First time I went to dinner at their home, he invited me over, and I didn't know Cindy and I didn't know Sean, and I really felt like a kindergartner sitting at the end of the table listening to the conversation. This also, is Cindy in here somewhere right now?
No.
No? Okay. Actually, that's good, because I love Cindy, she's my mom, but maybe that'd be additional pressure if she was watching me up here struggle on these songs. So she'll be by later, maybe I'll give her a hug. She said hi?
Yep.
Let's call her at 2. Anyway, she calls me her son. I'm proud of that.
Son of a what?
All right. This is one of my favorite songs that Jim ever wrote. And I recorded Educated Man, most of you know that, and I'm really proud of that. We'll play that in a little bit. But I think, so far, this is my second favorite song of Jim's, okay? And I play this wherever I go play. And the caribou tundra and the wild barren land, where all suffused are God's great old fair stand. The trail of the Eskimo hunters worn, ah, this is the country where legends are born. Where the northern lights blaze across the cold arcades, and the caribou come to an old shaman's drone. Saloons and mantles, they talked of the gold. There were stories of fortune, stories of gold. The trail of the weary gold miners worn. Ah, this is the country where legends are born. With a miserable man, by the gold in his hand, and the speed of his guns, and the dogs he would run. They came here to settle and build a new life, across the mountains and valleys, and the cabins he stand. The trail of the weary homesteader is worn. Ah, oh, this is the country where legends are born. These fields you see now were broke by plow, and the children have grown and built homes of their own. And the caribou tundra and the wild barren land, where all the fierce Arctic ice, where the polar bears stand. The trail of the Eskimo hunter is worn. This is the country where legends are born.
Yeah, man. Adam, we made it through a few of them.
Thank you. It's nice to be able to breathe in here again, honestly. I'm like singing right now. I hope it sounds okay. I still have it a little bit. But... has anybody been to Park City, Utah, by the way?
Yeah,
I did a show down there. Like, that's where I got this sinus infection. I just got over it. I had to get on antibiotics. But anyway, it's 8,000 feet there, and I was not used to that at all. So I was feeling like a little sissy there. Am I a sissy?
Yeah,
thanks. Is that my mom?
Yeah.
You are a sissy. All
right. How are you?
What are you doing?
We're filming right behind you.
Are you guys in town?
Cheryl. Excuse me, Cheryl. Can you move?
Just the hardworking ones? Good. He's in my friends in Rainy Past Loves, where we also perform out there. Actually, I went out there and played for Jim out there. And, so I think we're going back in a couple weeks. Yeah. Well, are you good over there? Yeah. You want to play some more fiddle for me? What do you want to do? I'll rest my throat for one song while you show up. Oh, you want to play for me? Adam wants to do a George Strait song for you. You know what? This is my first beer I had in 2 weeks. It's so good. Buffalo Trace. That was Jim's favorite bourbon. Yuck, yuck, yuck. Did you say yuck, yuck?
Yuck, yuck.
Oh, because yuck, yuck would be right. That was the only thing we didn't agree on. That stuff is...
1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Last night we hit a bad old mile down the road. Well, the money walked out and left his woman burning out of control. Well, I was down there about an hour or so with a little mountain bike. She was ready to go. I'm a fireman. That's my name. Well, they call me the fireman. That's my name. Making my rounds all over town.
Also, there's someone else I want to thank in here. The merch tent and all the merchandise over there that you see by the woodlot. And a lot of that was ramrodded by a guy that just loved Jim, hired Jim to perform at his home, and then they became friends, and then he partnered up with Sam, and they came up with all this great stuff. And like this shirt right here, show everybody your shirt, Marty. Sam, that I introduced you to earlier, designed that. And Jim Miller, who's sitting next to him, raise your hand, Jim. Jim has been a big force in pushing all that merch to keep it alive, everybody. Give these two guys a big round of applause. They're keeping Jim's spirit alive and shirts and the show. Chelsea also helped out with that right there. And there's probably other people that I'm not mentioning, but good to see you, buddy.
How do we get those shirts?
Okay. Shall we proceed? I'm gonna see what songs I got here. Dusty boots, bittersweet highways, lawns of freight trains. Riding through my memory, just a kid with that same old story, on the road and bound for glory. The soul guitar's found it low when I water Woody's road.
Are you guys the ones that made that shirt?
Small town.
$30.
Where
are they
sold
at?
You know where
the lumberjack show is?
Yeah.
After
the wind,
we're there every day.
Sleeping in the rain. I had my highs and I had my lows. When I wander way through, I hear you. Walk the mountains and her fertile valleys, city lights and dangerous dark alleys, coast to coast, singing every working man's tune, street corners and smoky old bar rooms. I follow my boots wherever they go. When I this land is your land, and this land is my land. You know I've seen it now from both sides of me. Done my best, but my troubles, they were many. Looking for them old pastures of plenty. Then my soul and seed to sow. When I want. Then I want to raise
right now, by the way. Yeah, keep practicing. That's good advice, whoever's. So, after, let's see. Today, and then like I said, I go down to Nashville, play a wedding Saturday, then September 5th in the Sluice Box, we're doing the tribute show for Hobo, which is always, he always played the last day of the fair. We're gonna do it with a full band, close the Sluice Box, and I called Joni Harms. Joni co-wrote a lot of songs with Jim, and she's gonna come up from Oregon. She's in the Country Western Music Hall of Fame, has some Grammy stuff. She's an excellent singer-songwriter, beautiful voice. So she's gonna join us in the Sluice Box. And then we collected some videos and old footage of Jim performing, some interviews, and we're assembling basically a 30, 40 minute slide movie presentation that we will play in the middle of that show that night. So let's pack the Sluice Box with Hobo Jim fans.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm gonna, thank you very much. Adam, we have gas money.
Sweet.
They're passing the bottle, the old anchor bar. There ain't no one going out fishing. There's a new wind been blowing over these docks. There's storm clouds in the distance.
Watching,
oh, catch these waters for 40 some years. Now sons and his daughters share their spears. The canneries are closing in this little town, cause there ain't no more fish, and the prices are down, and they're passing the bottom at the old anchor bar. There ain't no one going out fishing. There's an ill wind been blowing over these docks, and there's storm clouds in the distance. Those Saturday troubles took more than this year. They blamed all the foreigners who've been fishing out there. Poor regulation, or pollution, they claim. What the hell does it matter? It's all just the same. But you're passing the bottom in the old anchor bar. There ain't no one going out fishing. There's a new wind that'll blow over these docks. And there's storm clouds in the distance. Now proud machine vessels silently play, harbored and dry hop with their rotting decay. Season to season, untended downstairs, to all become theirs, forgotten by men who are passing the bottom at the old anchor bar. There ain't no one going out fishing. There's a new wind that'll blow over these docks, and there's storm clouds in the distance. Your turn.
They're passing the bottom in the old anchor bar.
Yeah.
There ain't no
one going out fishing.
There's a new
wind that's blowing over these docks, and there's
storm clouds in the distance. They're passing the bottom in the old anchor bar. There ain't no one going out fishing. There's a new wind that's blowing over these docks, and there's storm clouds in the distance.
Good singing. Good singing. Hello, Kitty.
I started learning some songs actually last night.
I learned three of them today.
What did you learn today? Which ones?
Forever Young.
Oh, cool.
The Rock.
The Rock. We did that.
Wild and Free.
A Wild and Free. Ooh. Who loves Wild and Free anyway? Isn't that cool? I don't need that. That's just my set list. Actually, it can stay there. Actually, can you flip that over so I can see what songs we haven't done? I don't really care.
I'll just lay it on.
You guys care if I do Wild and Free?
No.
You might after I do it. I have to read this one, maybe. I'm gonna test myself.
I wrote in where all the acoustic fills and the banjo fills are, but I didn't bring either of those.
Well, we can't do it.
Oh, you're
I learned. I didn't even learn it, obviously, if I'm still reading it. You know what? I have to tell you something. When I saw people put music stands on stage, I was like, How many people feel that way, right? When you see music stands, you're like, you don't know. You didn't learn the song. But when you're learning 20 Hobo Jim songs, then you get a pass.
Just for reference, though. You only need every other word.
You have an intro for this since you learned it?
No, I was letting Jerry take that.
Oh, Jerry was playing. Was Jerry coming today? Alright. Here's the intro.
There's a part of me wild and free. In my heart there's a promise. Hallelujah. That I've been on. There just doesn't seem to be an end to this room that I'm on. See that room spreading over the land. I see a young boy standing with a suitcase in his hand. It was long ago. Boy, it was me. And I was running like a wolf in the mountains, wild and free. I've got it in my mind that it must have been the time that made me a wild free. From a family to love and a warm mother, everybody knew it was just me. Wild and free. I didn't care at all which way I'd go. I didn't mind the hunger, the wind, or the rain, and the snow. Cause I was on the road. But I wanted to be just another man moving down the highway. Wild and free. Well, I got it in my mind that it must have been the time that made me all the way. From a family that I love and a warm group of fun, but everybody around me would say it was just me being wild and free.
Hey, you have a solo part right here.
There's a part of me still wild and free. In my heart there's a wild wolf howling through the tall pine trees. It's a long old dream that I've been on. There just doesn't seem to be an end to the road that I'm on. There just doesn't seem to be an end in this tale I've been gone.
Hey, that was the first time I ever performed that song. So, don't judge too harshly. It'll get better, I promise. Thank you for this moment of forgiveness. Actually, I love that song, too. You love that song? Is that one of your favorites? Actually, Adam, sorry I messed up your solo.
That's okay. I got thrown off by that random smoke that blew past me.
Was there smoke going by you?
Hi, Lisa. Hi, Lisa.
Oh, yeah, there's a little electrical thing in here. I smells it. I smells it good. It'll get clear what it is soon.
It's not come from
out there. Don't worry.
We got that. This might happen. Actually, you know what?
Oh, is this fiddle playing? What are you doing?
Orange Blossom special.
band 8 years and decides tonight to play Orange Blossom Special.
That's good.
Thanks.
Why don't you keep going?
My leg got tired.
Says no fiddle player ever.
My leg got tired. The little drummer boy over here is not keeping up.
Oh, I thought you said drama boy.
Oh, no.
Little drummer boy.
It just can't even.
You see how his little kick drum down there, his little digital.
Yeah, made a big old sub in here.
Crunches.
Crunches. One leg crunches.
Oh, some of this Legends are Born wants us to play.
Alright.
Can I play you one of my favorite country songs real quick before I jump back? Thank you. I was missing this song. I haven't seen it.
As we sat on the front porch of that old gray house where I was born and raised, staring at the dusty field when my daddy worked hard every day, I think it kind of hurt him, and I said, "Daddy, there's a lot that I don't know. But don't you really dream about a life where corn don't grow? He sat beside him, staring at his favorite coffee cup. I saw a storm of mixed emotion in his eyes when he looked up. He said, "Son, I know you're ready to see that this world is turning slow.
Ken, what's food? He gets food.
And you think you'll find the answer to it all? We're called on the road. All times are real. Dusty fields, no matter where you go. But you may change your mind, 'cause the weeds are higher where corn don't grow." Feeling guilty when daddy turned and walked back in the house. I was only 17 back then, but I thought that I knew more than I do now. I can't say it won't be. This city life's a hard road to hoe. It's funny how a dream can turn around where corn don't grow. Our times are real, there's dusty fields no matter where you go. And you may change your mind, 'cause the weeds are higher where corn don't grow. I remember feeling guilty When daddy turned and he walked back in the house, I was only 17 back then, but I thought that I knew more than I do now. But I can't say you didn't warn me, this city life's a hard road to hoe. Ain't it funny how a dream can turn around with cornrows? Our times are real, there's thirsty fields no matter where you go. And you may change your mind, cause we are higher with cornrows. You may change your mind.
Is that from you too? Oh wow. Okay, show's over, Tommy. Very much. Appreciate that. Thank you. How many people have seen this young lady singing around the fair right there? Everybody? Give it up for her. I just got $100 from this guy in the ball cap to do Educated Man. So. He just found out. I would love to do this. There were a few books on his shelf, same grade, and a Bible, and nothing else. Never went to foreign school, always thought himself a fool, so much he couldn't understand. But given the torch and some metal, not he could build anything in this world by God. When it came to working his hands, but he was an educated man. But he was a master of his trade, could fix anything ever made with his hand. Smarter than most PhDs, could build anything he sees with his hand. He was an educated man. Never traveled very far, he'd only leave his farm to pick up parts. And the only world he knew was a shop and all his tools, and the work he had to do. But give him a hammer and a box
lots of nails to get big, a wagon on a ship that sailed. But it came to working with his hands. He was an educated man, but he was a master of a trade. Could fix anything of a man with his hands. Smarter than most PhDs, could build anything you see with his hands. And he was an educated man. He walked here, he taught me all he knew. And when he left me all his tools. Well, here I am with his old chisel in my hand. Carly, here lies an educated man. Well, he was a master of the trade. He fixed anything in the maze with his hand. Smarter than most PhDs, can build anything you see with his hand. He was an educated man. He was an educated man.
My favorite song I ever played, just like Jim would say. So anyway, thank you all for coming. I said that, I'm like, I don't even know if anybody's gonna come. So I mean it. Thanks for coming. I mean it.
Thank you, Ken.
Yeah,
they were here to see Randy.
So
I like your hat. Yeah. No way, that's too much money. Thank you.
Allison, you're leaving, aren't you?
I thought I got my $100 bill because Barry didn't pay me. Thank you, that was really sweet. Oh, that smells. But I'm gonna play that song again. Get me a new hat. Thank you. See Adam? Place to play country music instead of violin. Very happy you learned the fiddle, aren't you?
Yeah. I don't have to wear that stuffy tux anymore.
Adam plays for the symphony, too. He's great. He really does. Play one more symphony song. This is your part. Play some of that Irish music. How many people have seen our guitar player Jerry play before? I mean, there's a big personality difference between Jerry and Adam. And Jerry gets done, he's like, Adam. Thank you.
Old school.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
I'm not as young as I used to be.
Yeah.
You still got it.
How about another hand for Randy, or a sound guy? How about a hand for our bartenders over here doing a fine job?
Yes!
Thank you. Oh, I thought you were bringing me that beer. I'll give you a 20. I've got a beer. Good to see you, buddy. Are you guys good for a few more songs? Hey, hats do that every now and then. Sorry. They just do. That's why I'm going to switch to a beret. I really used to walk around the fair with my kids in a beret so I could just keep walking. Remember that season? Oh, I don't like repeating songs, but I got a text from someone that came in late. They want to hear where legends are born. Is it okay if I do that one more time for you? Probably mess it up this time.
Maybe I messed it up last time. We had two chances.
50-50.
In the caribou tundra, in the wild bear land, across the fierce Arctic ice, where the polar bear stands. Trail of the Eskimo hunter is born.
Watch out!
Oh, this is the country where legends are born. Where the northern lights blaze across the cold arcades, and the caribou come to an ocean's roar. In saloons and in man's halls, they talk of the gold. Those stories of fortune, stories of gold. The trail of every gold miner is born. You didn't have to do that. This is the country where legends are born. Thank you. With a measured man by the gold in his hand, the speed of his gun, the dogs he would run. They came here to settle and build a new land. And the mountains and valleys and the cabins they stand. The trail of the Erie homesteader is born. Oh, this is the country where legends are born. These fields you see now were poor by plow. The children grown to build a home of their own. Wild bird land, across the fierce Arctic ice, where the polar bear stands. The trail of the Eskimo hunter is born. Ah, this is the country where legends are born.
Have beer.
What? You are now in a bar, so sit down.
You like that, ain't
it? When you have beer,
my first beer I've had in actually 2.5 weeks. It tastes so good. Thank you very much. Hi. Are there any musicians in here, Heidi? I know you are.
There's a musician right here.
Anyway. She'll sing one.
Better be careful.
He
might be.
Okay, someone asked for Red Dirt. That's actually... Is it you, Red Dirt? I can't see you. I did this on the third CD, right in the middle of that little stage four throat cancer journey. I met Waylon Jennings' original band in Anchorage at a hotel. And they came up to Alaska to do a Shriners benefit. And someone told them that I sing Waylon songs. And so they said, well, come and meet me. And let's talk about the show. And they said, what key do you do the songs in? I said, I do them in the same key. So I went in front of the band 1 hour later at West High Auditorium for the Shriners. And then we decided to record together. And this is one of the songs we recorded. By the way, I normally don't call this guy out, but I did radiation 5 days a week. And the guy that did my stuff and helped save my life is standing right over there. It was an awesome journey. I lost 54 pounds. It's a great weight loss program.
Oh, shit.
Anyway. Awesome crew. I got lucky. Thank you, Ben. Always good to see you, too. Anyway, this is one of the songs I did with Waylon's band. This is called Red Dirt.
Brought a little red dirt back with me on my boots. Brought a little red dirt back with me on my boots. I went back to Oklahoma. down, had them snake stars, little bucks, and I put them down, and I keep on looking, and I can't come around, these boots been up, down, dirty, but they're still around. Got a little red dirt bag, say it. I went back to Oklahoma, did that thing to do, got a little red dirt back with me. Oh, my. One more there, little man. Got a little red dude back with me on my boots. I went back to Oklahoma, did that thing to do. Got a little red dude back with me on my boots. I went back to Oklahoma, did that thing to do.
Adam, you made so many $100 bills tonight.
I worked hard for my money.
So hard for my money. Say it with your deep manly voice. Alright, we have a note here.
Let me do that.
From somebody.
I should be good on my charge.
How about a hand for Adam one more time on the fiddle there, please? Someone passed in this note when you were singing.
May I?
Dear Kim,
I think Adam is so pretty.
Did you write that note, Ken?
I wrote it.
Is that why you came to Seattle?
Yeah. He is Burry Mouth.